Last lecture, we discussed about generation of charge carriers in semiconductors. And before going to types of recombinations, first let us discuss about what is direct recombination, what is indirect recombination, and what is trap. So in this lecture, we discuss about these three terms. So we know that above absolute temperature or absolute zero temperature, thermal excitation of electrons from the valence band to the conduction band. That continuously generates free electrons or free electron and hole pairs. We know that in equilibrium, there should be some annihilation or recombination mechanism that returns the electron from conduction band down to an empty state that is hole in the valence band. So when a free electron wandering around in conduction band of a crystal, meets a hole in it falls into low energy state which is empty, and fills it. We know that this process is called recombination. So when an electron jumps from conduction band to valence band, in the valence band it meets with hole, and this process is known as recombination. We can also think that recombination occurs to the free electron . We can also think that recombinations, or we can say it, corresponds to that recombinations correspond to the free electron finding an incomplete bond with a missing electron. So in recombination, we can think that recombination correspond to the free electron that can find an incomplete bond with a missing electron. The electron then enters and complete that bond. The free electron in the conduction band and the free hole in the valence band are consequently annihilated. We can show it by an energy band diagram. That an electron that is wandering in the, this is conduction band we know, and this is valence band. This is EV and this is minima of the conduction band. So it can find a hole in the valence band. So by combining this electron to this hole, there is release of energy which is equal to Eg. So this type of recombination is known as direct recombination. For example, in gallium arsenide, in which free electrons recombine with a free hole, when they meet at one location, in the crystal. As I said earlier, the excess energy of the electron is lost as a photon of energy H mu, which is equal to band gap. In fact, it is this type of recombination that results in the emitted light from light emitting diode. The recombination process between electron and hole like every other process in nature. Must obey the momentum conservation law. Let psi c be the wave function of an electron in the conduction band the momentum of this electron will be that is if I am writing momentum as P, then it must be equal to H cross K C B. Similarly, for an electron in valence band, with wave function psi cb and wave vector kvb, the momentum of the electron will be, let's say it's PVB, which is equal to H cross KVB. Conservation of linear momentum during recombination requires that when the electron drops from conduction band to the valence band, its wave vector should remain the same. That is, we know that due to conservation of linear momentum, the momentum in conduction band should be equal to the momentum in valence band. Here h cross is constant, so we can say that for conservation of linear momentum, the wave vector of electron in conduction band should be equal to the wave vector of electron in the valence band. For the elemental semiconductor, semiconductors like silicon and germanium . The electronic states, that is psi VB with wave vector K VB, with KVB equal to KCB, are right in the middle of the valence band and are therefore fully occupied. Consequently, there are no empty state in the valence band that can satisfy this vector relation, and so direct recombination in silicon and germanium is not possible. Meaning is that We know that in silicon, this is conduction band and this is valence band. Since there is no empty state in the valence band, correspond to if here this KC and here KVB, then there is no empty state in the valence band. So this wave vector relation, that is KCB equal to KVB, is not possible in elemental semiconductors. Those have indirect band gap. But for some compound semiconductor, such as gallium arsenide and INSB, the states with KVB, which is equal to KCB, are right at the top of the valence band. So they are essentially empty or condensed holes. Consequently, an electron in the conduction band of gallium arsenide can drop down to an empty state at the top of the valence band and maintain KCB equal to KVB. Thus, direct recombination is highly probable in gallium arsenide, and it is this region that makes gallium arsenide an LED material. We can understand this direct and indirect phenomena by considering a direct band gap material just like gallium arsenide. This is conduction band and this is valence band. So first let us assume that at 0 Kelvin temperature these states, all the states of valence band are fully filled and all the states of conduction band are fully empty. So when we increase the temperature, some electrons, let's say here at this point, we know that here scale is K and this scale is E, that is energy. So at this point, let's say momentum is KVB and here momentum is KCB. So when we increase the temperature, the electrons which are near to this top of the valence band take energy and go to this conduction band. So we can see here that the electron near to top of the valence band are taking the energy and going to at the minima of the conduction band. So in this way, states near to the top of the valence band are empty, from where some electrons have gone to the conduction band, and near the minima of the conduction band there are some electrons. So here we can see that the wave vector of these electrons are equal to the wave vector of these electrons. So when there is a recombination process, this electron by emitting energy which is equal to this band gap jumps again to the valence band and recombine with the same hole or with the hole with same wave vector. So in this way, here we can see that momentum of electron in the conduction band is equal to the momentum of the electron in valence band, since here KCB is equal to KVB. But if we think this in indirect band gap semiconductor, these are direct recombination or direct band gap. But for indirect band gap semiconductor like silicon, we know that maximum of the valence band occurs at different value of K to the minimum of the conduction band. So now, if in silicon, when we increase the temperature, electrons from the top of the valence band get energy and go to the higher energy state, let's say in conduction band, by some indirect mechanism. So when if here the wave vector is KVB and here the wave vector KCB, and when an electron by emitting its energy wants to come again in the valence band, here we can see that there is a difference in wave vector. So here KCB not equal to KVB. So this type of recombination is known as indirect recombination. So let me write it again here. In elemental semiconductors, like silicon and germanium, electrons and holes usually recombine through recombination center. A recombination center increases the possibility of recombination because it can take up any momentum difference between a hole and electron. The process essentially involves a third party which may be an impurity atom or a crystal defect. A Here the electron is first captured by the recombination center. And thus becomes localized at that site. It is held at the center until some hole arises and recombines with it. So in indirect recombination, if this is valence band, and this is conduction band, this is EC, and this is EV. Let me draw here three diagrams. This is conduction band. So if there are some impurity with energy ER, so if there is an electron that is wandering around the conduction band, first it will get trapped in recombination center and let's say hole is here, which is not directly below this electron. So let's now electron is at this recombination center. So now this electron will wait for a hole so that this hole can go under this electron, and when this electron or this hole move in this direction, and when this hole comes directly under this electron, then this electron will recombine with this hole by emitting a phonon. So this is the process of recombination in indirect band gap semiconductors, or this is the process of indirect recombination. Typical recombination centers besides the donor and acceptor impurities might be metallic impurities and crystal effects. Such as dislocations, vacancies, or interstitial each has its own peculiar behavior in aiding recombination. So from here we can see that in indirect band gap semiconductors, direct recombination is not possible. For recombination, there must be some impurities in the role of donor acceptor, or some vacancies, or some other defects. So for recombination in indirect band gap semiconductors, these defects are essential. Now let's know about what is trap or trapping. We know that this charge trapping could be main limiting factor on the performance in many electronic devices. An electron in the conduction band can capture by a localized state or center, just like a recombination center. Located in the band gap the electron falls into the trapping center at ET and becomes temporarily removed from the conduction band. So as we discussed for recombination center, for trapping center, the situation looks the same. Just like recombination center, there are some trapping center with energy ET. So similarly, this is conduction band. This is valence band. If there is an electron, let me draw two more diagrams. So here is trapping center. So first this electron will go to this trapping center. So an electron trapped by this trapping center can be temporarily removed from the conduction band and at a later time due to an incident energetic lattice vibration it becomes excited again and goes to this conduction band. So let me write it here that at a later time due to an incident energetic lattice vibrations it becomes excited back into the conduction band and is available for conduction again. Thus, trapping involves the temporary removal of electron from the conduction band whereas in the case of recombination the electron is permanently removed from the conduction band since the capture is followed by recombination with a hole. Here we can see a trap as essential in the crystal that results in the location of or in the creation of a localized electronic state around its site. with an energy in the band gap. A charge carrier passing by it can be captured and lose its freedom. The trapping center can be an impurity or a crystal imperfection in the same way as a recombination center. The only difference is that when a charge carrier is captured, at a recombination site, it has no possibility of escaping again because the center aids recombination with the whole. So, in this way, in this lecture, we have discussed about direct recombination, indirect recombination, and traps. We also see that what are the differences between recombination centers and trapping centers. So, in next lecture, we will discuss about various types of recombination.